Hi everyone, welcome to Embedded in IoT Enthusiast Learning Space. Today we will be discussing about MEMS magnetometer. This is in continuation of the series we are having on MEMS sensors. In previous video we discussed about accelerometer and then gyroscope, and in today's video we'll be discussing about magnetometer, and we'll be talking about how it works, what is MEMS, and what are the key applications for MEMS magnetometer. Let's get started. What is MEMS magnetometer? MEMS magnetometer is small-scale microelectromechanical system device for detecting the magnetic field. MEMS magnetometer is used to measure the magnetic field experienced by the device, particularly with respect to its orientation. So what it measures? It measures the magnetic field strength. And magnetic field strength is typically measured in Gauss or Tesla or micro Tesla. So the calibrated magnetic field strength is used to calculate the magnetic heading. So magnetic heading is the key use case that we use in our all smartphones. You will be seeing one application called eCompass. So we'll talk about it in detail. And magnetometer is mainly packaged in the same die along with accelerometer and gyroscope. So typically it's packaged with gyroscope because we need tilt compensated compass. So we need to do the tilt compensation with respect to the gyroscope. Now let's discuss the magnetometer working principle. So MEMS magnetometer make use of an experience or a phenomena called Hall effect, which works on a principle that voltage can be detected across a thin metallic element or thin metallic surface when it is experienced a strong magnetic field perpendicular to its element plane. So when current carrying conductor experiences a magnetic field perpendicular to its surface, the voltage is detected. So this is called Hall effect. Why this voltage is detected? The voltage is detected because of the magnetic field, the current flow get unevenly distributed, and that's the reason the voltage or the potential is generated across the electrode or across the plane of that surface. Now if you see the equation, so VH, which is the Hall voltage, is equal to RH 1 by T multiplied by B. RH is the Hall effect coefficient, I is the current flow through the sensor, so I is the current flow that is basically flowing on the surface of the sensor, T is the thickness of the sensor in mm, and B is the magnetic field or magnetic flux density that is experienced by this perpendicular to the surface. The detected voltage is referred to as the Hall voltage, and this overall phenomena is called Hall effect. Now let's deep dive on what we can measure with the magnetometer. So if you see, this is a MEMS magnetometer. Now if you see, I have x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. So this is a tri-axis magnetometer. It can measure magnetic field experience in x-axis, y-axis and the z-axis. So MEMS magnetometer is used to measure the magnetic field, particularly with respect to its magnetic strength and the orientation. So orientation is referred to all the three axes. A popular example of magnetometer would be compass. So if you see, this is the snapshot of the compass applications. And magnetic heading is defined as the angle in the local horizontal magnetic plane clockwise from true north. So what is the angle we are having in our plane with respect to the true north is called as the magnetic heading. So, and if you see, if you rotate yourself in 0 to 360 degree, and you will see that the angle from your true magnetic north is also varying from 0 to 360 degree. Now, if you, the derivation of magnetic heading is nothing but the A10 of Hy by Hx, and this basically changes based on the orientation. So, if you are in a different orientation, the calculation of heading changes with respect to orientation, as well as we need to do the basically tilt compensation. So this is a very straight derivation which is written, but we need to do tilt compensation because what may happen that our plane may be rotated, right? Our plane, reference plane, may be tilted. We will have some pitch, or we can have some roll or some yaw. Then accordingly we need to basically have and basically get the sine and cos component of that particular the rotation frame, and then calculate the magnetic heading. Now if you see, we have magnetic north and we have true north. Now true north is a fixed point in the globe. If you see in this globe, true north is the fixed point. However, magnetic north is not a fixed, so it keep on changing. So why it is changing? Because of the magnetic north pole and south pole, because the changes over time in response to the change in the earth magnetic pole, and this angle is called magnetic declination. Now let's discuss the key application we can have with respect to MEMS magnetometer. So one of the main application what we discussed that we can use for navigation is e-compass. So e-compass is one of the key application, and this we do with the tilt compensation. And another thing is the indoor navigation. So once we have e-compass, so that can be used in indoor navigation. So in indoor navigation, if we know the magnetic heading, then we can do triangulation with respect to some absolute location which is having the latitude and longitude, and we can basically do the triangulation and calculate our orientation in the indoor plane. And another thing is the IMU, which is like inertial measurement unit, which is being used in aircrafts, UAVs, and which is having a combined package with gyroscope, accelerometer and magnetometer. Cameras are using for SLAM using sensor fusion, and this can be used for geographical surveys, oil and gas exploration, metal detection and coal exploration, because the ferromagnetic property changes, and due to this your magnetometer will be sensing differently in comparison to the normal sensing. Now, what are the design consideration we should keep in mind while selecting magnetometer? So one thing is the sensitivity. So what is the millivolt with micro tesla or millivolt micro tesla with LSP? So the sensitivity is the key criteria. So we need to basically check the sensitivity aspect of the magnetometer. The next thing is the range. So what is the full scale range of the magnetometer in terms of cos or the tesla? Third thing is the sensitivity change with respect to temperature. So it should not be very sensitive with respect to temperature. As the temperature changes, the magnetometer reading is highly deviating. So we need to check this aspect. So apart from that, the power, basically what is the active power, what is the sleep power, what is the normal operating power in terms of the milliampere. So this is also the key application, because at least battery operated devices, when we are using for it can be also one of the key application is in the robotics, right? The robotic navigation in indoor scenario, so they will be battery operated, so we need to make sure that they should be having a low power mode. And these are the key vendors, so ST Micro, Bosch, Invensys and AKM, and these are some of the key sensors that I have used, and these are very popular and that are being used in at least in the commercial applications or in the consumer products.